In this video, we'll take a look at the columns block, which you can use to create a grid with up to 6 columns. Then you can insert text, media, or other types of content into each column. To add a columns block, click the block inserter button and then search for the columns block. Or type a forward slash on a new line followed by the word columns. Then press enter to add the columns block. Next, choose the number of columns you'd like to start with, and you can always change the number or click the plus icon between any two columns to add additional columns later. In the toolbar, click the button on the left to select the entire columns block. Then you can change the width of the entire columns block or the vertical alignment of the blocks relative to each other. And now we're ready to start adding some content to each column. The great thing about the columns block is that you can add other blocks into each column. So, for example, you can use the columns block to create the structure and then add image blocks, heading blocks, or paragraph blocks to create a grid of services. Or you might add cover image blocks to feature certain pages on your site. So you can use column blocks to create just about any type of layout you want. When you're finished adding content, click the button on the left of the toolbar to select the entire column. And you can use the arrows to move the entire column to the left or right. And once again, you can change the vertical alignment of the content in this column relative to the other columns on either side. To select the parent columns block, click the button on the left-hand side of the toolbar. There are some additional settings for the columns block. To access those settings, click the Options button and select Show More Settings. Here, once again, you can change the number of columns in the block and choose whether or not you'd like the columns to appear in a stack, one on top of the other, when this page is viewed on a mobile device. If you want, you can even modify the colors used for the text that appears within each column, or select a background color for the entire columns block itself. And finally, you can adjust the spacing around each column, or padding, by entering a different number of pixels here. And if you click the button to unlink the sides, you can get even more specific by entering different values for the top, right, bottom, and left of each column. Or click the ellipsis button to show additional options that allow you to change the margin and even the space between the blocks in each column. So, as you can see, with all of these options, the columns block can be incredibly flexible and can help you create just about any type of custom layout you might need. For more help with blocks, please visit wordpress.com/support.